You are listening to an update from Washington with the congressman from Alabama's 1st Congressional District, Bradley Byrne. Now from our nation's capital, Congressman Byrne.
Well, welcome in to this edition of An Update from Washington. This is Seth Morrow, and we're joined once again with Congressman Bradley Byrne. And today we're going to talk about the congressman's Ag Matters Tour. Congressman, can you just kind of tell us what this tour is all about?
Yeah, we wanted to go and see both the agricultural and forestry industries in my district, and we have both of those in every county in my district. So we started out in Baldwin County on Thursday and ended in Mobile County on Friday, and we saw every type of agriculture just about that we've got in my district and saw a number of forestry areas and forestry industries and mills, et cetera. So it was real good tour, learned a lot, talked to a lot of good people, and learned a lot about a very important industry to my district.
And I understand that one of the big challenges facing both our farmers and our foresters are regulations from Washington. And one of those regulations I'm sure you heard a lot about was the Waters of the U.S. rule. Can you tell us what that is and why it upsets our farmers so much?
Well, what the Waters of the U.S. does is it empowers the federal government to tell you what you can and can't do with a mud puddle in your farm field or in your forestry land or in your front yard. So it's a big limiter on what our farmers and the people in our forestry industry can do. And by the way, every time we put one of those regulations on and it forces them to do more, it just costs the consumer more. It just makes the food that you and I buy at the grocery store cost more. So we're going to push back against these regulations every way we can, not just for the farmers and for the people involved in the forestry industry, but also for the rest of us to go and buy food at the grocery store.
Another one of those regulations we hear a lot about relates to the Endangered Species Act and how the federal government is halting certain activities on some of this farmland and forest land. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, we've had some where they're actually limiting it because a snake called the black pine snake, and we're working with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service to get a safe harbor from that provision for all of our forestry communities throughout the state of Alabama. We're actually fairly hopeful about that based on some recent conversations with Fish and Wildlife Service. But it's not just that species. It's also the long-eared back. It's also the eastern diamondback rattlesnake. It's also the gopher tortoise. And anybody's grown up around here, you know that we've got those all over southwest Alabama. It's not just in one place. It's all over. I question whether they're even threatened, much less endangered. But at least we can do is try to get some protection for our foresters and for our farmers so that they can do what they need to do and still be in compliance with federal regulations.
And earlier this year, I know the House passed a bill to repeal what is commonly known as the death tax. Understand that's important to our farmers. Why is that?
Well, you know, you think about it, if you're a farmer or you're a family forester, a lot of your money is tied up in your land. And in the case of a farmer, a lot of it's tied up in equipment, too. Well, that makes it sound like, quote, you're a rich person because you've had a heavy investment in that. You're really not. And if you have to sell anything off in order to pay your taxes, you've essentially undone what you tried to create. So a man and woman may spend their whole life building for their family a nice farm, and then their children have to sell the farm to pay the taxes that the federal government's trying to collect just because daddy's died. And that's just wrong. We should not impose a tax like that on the next generation. Their mom and dad paid the taxes while they were building everything. The children shouldn't have to sell off the farm to pay them after they die.
And Congressman, I know we're running out of time here, but if you could just quickly tell us about the Farm Bill and why that matters to our foresters and farmers.
Well, we passed the Farm Bill last year that was an update on all the federal agricultural laws. By the way, it was the first entitlement reform we've had in decades, and so that was welcome. But it also streamlined a lot of things, saved money for the taxpayers, and still provided the help that our farming community and our forestry community needs in order for them to continue to be the best in the world. And that's what they are. So I was very proud to be a supporter of that Farm Bill, and it seems to be paying off right now.
Well, we're out of time, but thanks for listening, and we'll talk to everyone next week.
You have been listening to An Update from Washington with Congressman Bradley Byrne. Congressman Byrne encourages you to contact him with any comments or questions. You can email him online at byrne.house.gov or find him on Facebook under U.S. Representative Bradley Byrne. Stay tuned to this station next week for another timely report from our nation's capital. This broadcast has been pre-recorded.